I think you need a genuine commitment from the industry to actually put in place the things that have been talked about. You know, so I think one of the greatest benefits that has come out of the dialogue so far has been that we've all learnt a huge amount from each other. And every time we meet, I know that I come away thinking, gee, I didn't know that before. It's really interesting to know that, and I can start to understand where they're coming from. I think the major challenge for the dialogue is to get it better known in our community, and we've talked about this quite a bit whenever we've met. The second major challenge, I think, is to actually demonstrate improvements on the ground, and I'm yet to see those.
I think it's done well in delivering some of the projects that have been put forward, and certainly the continuation of the discussion and the engagement has been really positive. Noting that a lot of the people are volunteering their time, so it's been positive that engagement continues. In terms of what we can do better, I think we've still got some ground to cover on the journey to true collaboration. I think there are still some barriers we need to break down, but over time with continued engagement and delivery of projects as expected, I'm confident we'll achieve that.
The industry has realised, I think, that those of us who have been noisy about coal mining issues are not complete idiots. We're not working on any basis of self-interest. It's about a matter of our concern for the community at large.
What we need to do better is just communicate our successes to the wider community. We've got a core representative community members from the Valley that attend the meetings and that are very well knowledgeable about what's going on in the industry, and I think it's our challenge now to broaden that group and get that message out.
I think the project that's been developed to try to make better use of 2 to 3 day weather forecasts to get the different mines to then work on the basis of that to plan a strategy for dealing with those bad days. That project, I believe, has enormous benefit, not only in terms of cutting down the level of pollution in the air, but also in terms of how it might be extended to the community in general to make the community also more aware of the days in which they should be take particular care.
I also think that there are some really exciting possibilities now in terms of providing real-time information back into communities from mining companies. And we've seen the start of that with the air quality monitoring network. The door is only just starting to open there about how computing power can not only monitor what we are doing, but start to be really good at predicting what will happen out into the future.
The Upper Hunter Air Quality Monitoring Network has been a terrific invention. I think it's giving us a huge amount of information that we never had before, and it has validated our concerns. The matter of voids, I think, is an example of where the dialogue has not gone far enough as yet when we're talking about land rehabilitation. Because we have actually talked about voids occasionally, but generally it's the elephant in the room. Everyone's got it in the back of their mind, what are we going to do with these bloody great big holes when the mines have actually gone?
That's an issue that's come up in the last 6 to 12 months, I think, and it's been driven by the community. And also, I think it's certainly on the radar with the regulators as well. And I think it's an interesting project that, for example, the land and management group are going to be working on in the next sort of 6 to 12 months. And I think we'll all be surprised of what uses we can make of this final landform shape, you know. And I think it'll challenge some perceptions and expectations on what can be done and what can't be done. And certainly not just in the industry and the community, but also with the regulators. I think it'll challenge their view as well. So it'll be an interesting project.
My hopes for the dialogue for the future is that it will continue to operate, that the Minerals Council and the coal miners will actually see benefits coming from it, that the community will be able to see improvements on the ground, and that more people will become involved in it.